Okay. So this is a fourth lecture. So in this lecture, what we are going to see, okay, this is closure of some relationship. What happens sometime is the relationship, whatever I have defined, the relation whatever I have defined is somewhat not complete, which means in the initial examples, whatever we have seen, one of the relation was not reflexive. One of the relation was not symmetric. One of the relation was not transitive. So at those times, actually, what do I do? Can I, you know very well that actually the relation is nothing but a subset of somebody, right? Like, so can I increase a little more people in the subset or add some more people in the subset and then form a new relation and then tell that that is reflexive now, or that is symmetric now, or that is transitive now. Okay. So an incomplete relation is completing it. It's called actually finding the closure of the relation. What do I mean by that? Imagine, as I remember, if you add somebody in the relation set, then the relation is actually getting changed. But the advantage is, you add somebody does not affect actually who are all already related to each other. Okay. If anybody related to each other, then that is not affecting by adding somebody. If you remove, of course, it's going to affect. So now I am going to add somebody so that I can make that relation is a little more bigger, so that what I want. What I wanted that new fellow to be reflexive. I wanted the new fellow to be symmetric. I wanted the new fellow to be transitive, at least one of them. Or in other words, according to my needs. Okay, that's what we are going to do today. So typically speaking, you see, this is my whole set, okay, A cross A, and I know that this fellow is my relation. I don't know who is this fellow, but this is some relation, but this fellow is not reflexive. So what I try to find is, actually there are points here in the cross product, there are points here. Can I find somebody else over here so that I can add these people also with this R and then call now together everybody as R1 or R star or R plus, whatever the name you wanted to give, as reflexive relation or not. Remember, this actually includes the previous relation, correct? And I want to call this as a closure, which means how tightly you can form, that tightly you have to form. What do I mean by that? If you have somebody else, so obviously you take A cross A, that's going to be reflexive. You take A cross A itself, it's going to be reflexive because this contains everybody here. That's why it's going to be definitely reflexive. But I don't want that. I want somebody actually who is really, really close to R, contains R, and still it is reflexive. Which I mean, if you find anybody who are having reflexive relation containing R, that has to be outside this R, that has to contain the R1, then I call that R1 is the closure of that relation. Call that R1 as closure of me. I should not be if I find anybody else who is smaller than that R1 and then be reflexive. That should not happen. That's what closure means. So reflexive closure means I have to find an R1 which contains R and it is very close to R. In other words, there is nobody else in between R and R1 which are reflexive. Only R1 is the next set which is reflexive. If I want a symmetric closure, then I have a relation and then I have to find one more set which contains R and nobody else is going to be in between R and R1 which are going to be reflexive. Sorry, which are going to be symmetric. Then R1 is the closure of R with respect to symmetric, or in other words, symmetric closure of R. Similarly, transitive. If R is not transitive, then I'm going to find somebody who is close to R, who is containing R, who is going to be transitive. Therefore, I'm going to call that fellow as transitive closure. Is that clear for everybody? Okay. Question. Good question, but actually that is not question was, sir, reflexive and symmetric, actually you are taking closure, whether symmetric and transitive you are taking the closure, whether reflexive also comes along with that as a bonus or not, that's what actually question. I don't know. No idea. Not sure. That's not true. Okay, there's no guarantee that actually I can give that actually you find a transitive closure, that will be symmetric closure also. You find a symmetric closure, that will be transitive closure also. You find a reflexive closure, that will be transitive closure also. No, I can't say that. That makes it difficult. Okay. Okay, anyway, actually in this syllabus, there is, I'm not going to find the reflexive closure or I'm not going to find the symmetric closure. I'm going to find something called a transitive closure, which is going to make a relationship as transitive by changing the relationship, but the relationship will also be inside the new relationship. Okay, so I'm going to find transitive closure. Okay, again, finding transitive closure is not so easy job. As you know, I have to check A and B, and then B and C related means, then I have to connect who and all. A and C. If A and B are related and B and C are related, then I have to collect A and C. Which means if A and C, A comma C is not there in the relation, then I have to add that fellow to make that as transitive closure. So like that, I have to find everybody. Okay, 1 and 2 are related, 2 and 3 are related, then I have to find 1 and 3. If that 1 and 3 is not there in the relation, then I have to bring them and then put it in them and then find and make it as transitive closure. Okay, now I have to say, okay, 1 and 3 are now related. Now 1 and 3 are related, so 3 and 2 may be related in some other else. Then find these people, therefore 1 and 2 also must be related, then bring the 1 and 2 and then put it inside. And similarly, now okay, 2 and 3 came inside, so 2 and 3 are related and 3 and 4 are related, therefore 2 and 4 also should be related. If 2 and 4 are not there, then I have to bring them also inside and then put it in. So it's a recursive process. You add somebody, then actually you putting somebody inside means actually you are actually creating trouble. Telling that actually whatever is there, I have to be related to other people also. So how do I actually confirm that? So each and every time you have to go ahead and find new people and add, and finally you will reach a saturation state that actually, okay, now I am complete. Now I have a transitive. There you stop. Obviously, we need an algorithm to do that. We need some procedure to do that. Somebody has to help me. Somebody has to tell me that actually, okay, proceed in this way, definitely you will get it. Okay, there comes our Stephen Warshall. So Stephen Warshall is an American computer scientist. It's a very very kind of very very naughty guy, I can say. He can't sit on the table and then do the work. He has to roam around and run around. He used to work all whenever actually he is sailing. Okay. He has done his graduated from Harvard, and he has worked in operation research office, which is one of the parts of the program by John Hawkins, which is actually working for American Army, so improvising and analyzing the data from the American Army system. Okay, he was working for that, and of course he has changed his positions, and of course we worked with many big shots and all. Okay, but he has a habit of actually, if he had to work very sincerely, then he has to do something else, not just sitting in the table and working. Very funny guy he is. Okay, you know, he found the algorithm for transitive closure on a bed of the bottle of rum. Okay, so he bet with this friend and saying that actually, no, okay, I will find the algorithm for transitive closure for what? For one bottle of rum. He won that in the overnight. He found the algorithm overnight, and the next day actually he got his rum also. Okay. Instead of actually telling you what is the procedure, rather than I would like to solve a problem by using that algorithm and explain you in the stepwise. Okay. So what do I have to do to solve this? So using Warshall's algorithm. This algorithm is called as Warshall algorithm. Earlier it was called as transitive closure algorithm. After that actually it's been named as Warshall algorithm. So Warshall algorithm is used to find transitive closure of a relation. So find the transitive closure of the relation 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 3, and 3, 4 on the set A equal on the set A equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 R is equal to 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 3, and 3, 4. Okay, set is A. I would like to represent it in a matrix form. Okay, let's say the matrix representation of the relationship. Okay, I know this is going to be 1, 2, 3, 4 in the row and also 1, 2, 3, 4 in the column. Who are all related? 1 and 2 are related. Therefore, 1 and 2 is going to be 1. 2 and 1 are related. Therefore, 2 and 1 is going to be 1. 2 and 3 are related. Therefore, 2 and 3 are is going to be 1. And 3 and 4 are related, therefore 3rd row 4th column is going to be 1. Rest all is going to be 0. So 110, 31, 130, 140, 220, 240, 310, 320, 330. Similarly 4th all out. Is that representation is clear for everybody? Just put 1 for who are all related. If 1 and 2 are related, therefore at the place of 1 comma 2 it's 1, otherwise 0. As I told, it's a recursive plot. So Warshall told, start with the first column and then first row. So let's find W naught is the initial matrix, which is nothing but the MR itself. Okay, therefore it's going to be 0 1 0 0 1 0 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 0. This is going to be the W naught initial matrix, first matrix. I'm going to find W1. So who is going to be W1 is the question. How do I find W1? Okay, the process is this. Look at first column and identify the indices where 1 is there. Who are all the places? Means indices is the index, first column, is it the first row or second row or third row or fourth row? Okay, in the first row, in the first column. So look at the first column and at what place 1 is there? 2. Therefore you mark the second as 2, second row. Rest all is empty. Therefore this is going to be just 2. Keep it as that much. And now look at the first row. Start with the column always, okay? Start with the column and start with the row after that. What happened? Where? 1. Look at the first column. Hey, kindly listen to my words and then write it, okay? Please don't look at here. It's a horrible handwriting. So look at first column and identify the indices where 1 is there. Okay. Just for sake of you understanding, actually I am writing it colloquially. If I properly write the algorithm, I think you will scold me back. Nothing understanding, everything going above head, everything will do. Okay. So this is the first set I have identified. What is the second set? And I will look at the first row and again identify the indices of columns having 1 again. Okay. So who are those people? Those are going to be look at the first column now, sorry, first row now, and who is going to be that? Only this fellow, right? Therefore, again, this is also 2. Okay. Before doing all these things and all, first bring all, but now we are ready to construct W1. So how do I how do I construct W1? Okay. Now I'll use a new page here. Therefore, include the elements. Include the elements. The set I found from the row indices, and the set I found from the column indices, and cross product it. What do you get? Only one element, that is 2, 2. In the include. Include one. I'm sorry for this. In the place where the indices are given by the set. So what do I get is W1 is equal to, this is 1, 2, 3, 4 is there, 1, 2, 3, 4 is there. At 2, 2, you add 1. Rest all you bring it from the W0. So what is W0? W0 is 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, right? So 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0. But at this place, what I have done, actually I found a new place to put 1 here. So therefore, 1, 0, what was that? 1, 0. Therefore, 1, 0. And rest all is same, 0, 0, 0, 1. 0, 0, 0, 1, and then 0, 0, 0, 0. This is W1. So what I have done here is, from the W0, I have taken all the people from the W0, which are 1s. Okay, I did not care about the zeros right now. Then after that, I have found the row indices and column indices and done a cross product of it, and then find a new places to put 1. So new places to put 1 is only one place, that is 2, 2, that gave me 1. So put that 1 and then fill the remaining by the previous matrix entries. The previous matrix entries gave you the new matrix. Now next, now we have finished only one row. Now we have 3 more rows to finish. Okay, next one. I have to write W2. As I have already told you, bring all the ones from the W1. So 1, 2, there is 1, and then 2, 1, 2, 2, all these places actually having 1. That we will write, finally write. Before that, what we do is, we'll do the work. So the indices where the second column has 1, or can you tell me who are those? Look at the second column, and where are the people who are having 1? First and second, right? So 1 and 2. So 1, 2 are the set. And similarly, the indices where the second row has 1 R, look at the previous matrix. Second row is this. Where are the ones? 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 3 places. First place, second place, and third place. So therefore, 1, 2, 3. Now, what is the procedure? Include 1 in the places mentioned by or given by the cross product of 1 comma 2 and 1 comma 2 comma 3. What is the cross product of 1 comma 2? That is 1 comma 1, 1 comma 2, 1 comma 3 and 2 comma 1, 2 comma 2 and 2 comma 3. Am I right? This is the cross product. This is the new position that actually I have to put 1 here. So 1 comma 1 position is here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Therefore, 1 comma 1 position is 1, 1 comma 2 position also 1, 1 comma 3 position also 1, and 2 comma 1 is also 1, 2 comma 2 is also 1, 2 comma 3 is also 1. Now, the rest of the entries I have to fill it from where? W1. So, look at the W1 and fill the rest of the entries. So, 2 comma 4 entry of W1 is 0. And so, this is 0. And of course 1 comma 4 entry is there, no? 1 comma 4 of entry of W1 is again 0, therefore this is 0. 3 comma 1, 3 comma 2, 3 comma 3, 3 comma 4, everything is from the previous entry. So that is 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0. So 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0. Any doubts? W2 has been derived from the new set of points as well as from the old one, W1. Now we left with 2 more matrices. Okay. So how do I find the 2 more matrices? So now I have to find the indices of third column where 1s are there. Who are they? Look at that fellow. In what? In W2. In W2. So, in the third column means this column. This is the third column. So, first position and then the second position. So, 1 and 2. And similarly, the indices of third row where 1 are there is nothing but, check your third row, that is here, is only at the fourth place there is 1. Therefore, this is nothing but just 4. Correct? This implies include 1s in the places, 1s in the places where I have to find the cross product of 1 comma 2 and 4, which is 1 comma 4 and 2 comma 4, only these two places. So the W3 is going to be equal to 1 comma 4 entry, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1 comma 4th entry is going to be 1 and 2 comma 4th entry is also going to be 1. Remaining entries are going to be coming from W2. So what is W2? 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1 in the first two rows. So 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. What is the third? 0, 0, 0, 1. Then last row is always 0. So 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0. That's it. I have only one step left. That is the last row and last column. In fact, last column and last. So, look for the indices of fourth column where 1s are there. Who are those people? In what? In W3. In W3. So, in fourth column, look at these people, 1, 2, 3, first position, second position, third position. So, 1, 2 and 3. Actually, this is in W3. And similarly, the indices of fourth row where ones are there in W3, or what is the fourth row? Empty set, nothing. Okay, therefore there is nothing to include. There is, am I right? Because you can, you cross product with empty set, you get nothing, right? So nothing to be included for W4 newly. So there is nothing to be included newly for W4. Therefore W4 is going to be the old one only, that is W3 itself. That's going to be equal to 1 1 1 4 ones, and of course 4 ones, 1 1 1 1, and then again 4 1. Yes, so all the column entries are ones, and then 0001 0001, and then 4 zeros. This gives the transitive relation. Therefore what is the answer? So answer is, actually this here stops the procedure. So I finish all the four columns, therefore I stop the procedure. That's what Warshall's algorithm says. So you come until the last column and find the matrix, and that gives you the relationship. Now what is the relationship? Therefore the transitive closure, therefore the transitive closure is, let me write the matrix here so that it will be easy for me. 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 0 0 1, and then 4 zeros. Okay, this is 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4. Can I write the relation now? How do I write the relationship? 1 comma 1, there is a relation, and then 1 comma 2, there is a relation. I hope you understand why I'm writing the relations, right? Wherever there is a 1, then write, find the indices and club them up, and then tell them that actually you have, you two are actually having relationship. That's it. So 1 comma 2, 1 comma 3, and 1 comma 4. Can you spell out? 2 comma 1, 2 comma 2, 2 comma 3, 2 comma 4, and then 3 comma 4. Anything else? Well, this is the new relation, which is a closure, which I have written as R plus, transitive closure. Okay. The transitive closure of R. Look at your R. R was, I think, only 4 elements were there, right? We had only 4 elements in R. Now we have added 5 more elements in R, and then made it as a new relation. Now you check, it will be transitive. How do I check transitivity? Look at 1 comma 1. So 1 comma 1 and 1 comma 2 are related. Therefore, who else has to be there? 1 comma 2 has to be there. Is that 1 comma 2 is there? Yes. Correct? 1 comma 1 and 1 comma 3 are related. And therefore, 1 and 1 are common. Therefore, 1 and 3 should be related. Is that 1 and 3 are related? Yes. Let's take a different example. 1 comma 2 and 2 comma 3 are related. Therefore, 2 are common. Therefore, who else has to be, who has to be related? 1 comma 3 are related. 1 comma 3 are there. Okay. You check any two pairs, actually it will be relation. So Warshall's algorithm is that much powerful that you cannot miss any such pair. Is it great? Okay. Okay. That's all for today. I will actually give you exercises in the portal. I'll upload the questions in the portal and then ask for it. Any questions? Warshall algorithm is clear? Easy. What you have to do? Look for the first column and first row. Check who are all ones in the first column, collect it as a set. Check who are all ones in the first row, collect it as a set. Cross product these two sets, that gives you new entries for W1, right? And then put those put ones in those places wherever I have the indices in the new Cartesian product. Then bring the rest of the entries from the previous iteration. I had to start with an initial matrix, which is W0, which is going to be the relation itself, because I want them to be always there. Is that correct? Any issues? correct? Okay, then we'll leave. Thank you so much.